Well, hello everybody. It is Wednesday night, the 9th of September 2015, and it is Take 5 for you. This is the time where we have set aside a time that is designed with the purpose of making a difference in your life. A difference in your life so you can make a difference in somebody else's life. As you listen to the Word of God, as I share it, as I put in my ideas, my thoughts, and then you declare, we declare together what God is doing. We make recordings. I hope you're doing this. We're at day 23. And in those times that we can reflect upon the things that God has placed upon our heart, this is what we do. This is the purpose of having what I'll call today a spiritual health check. Yesterday we talked about walking out your own salvation. The Apostle Paul talked about that in Philippians. Today we're going to look about the things that will help you as you walk out or work out your salvation. Because you see, we have a responsibility. It isn't just an automatic thing. You know, we just go in, we check our card, we get our card punched, and then everything is just okay. It's not that way. I'd just like to think about this. If you are following the spiritual battle that we're in currently around the world, there is a spiritual battle that is going on for the hearts and minds of men, particularly between Christianity and Islam. You can go on various websites, Muslim websites, and listen to Islamic apologists as they give their testimonies of how Christians have converted to Islam. Now, I'll put it this way. There are other Christians that have died and said, we will not convert. We will not reconvert. And you've read the stories, you've seen the articles, you've seen even perhaps some of the videos on Facebook or YouTube. It's for real. But I'll put it this way. For those that proclaimed Christ and now Muslims are proclaiming that they left their faith for a better faith, I'll put it this way. They did not walk out their own salvation. They did not work on it. They did not develop it. They had no true, lasting relationship with Almighty God. I'm not judging them. I'm not condemning them. I'm just telling you what I know. That once you are a Christian, you proclaim Christ as your Lord and Savior, you partake of water baptism, it's not all over. You have an entire written Word of God that is designed for you to grow and develop the potential that God placed in you. It isn't, we're not robots. We're not robots. We are called to love God, and it is a choice that we make. Even as married couples, Diane and I have been married almost 42 years. It'll be 42 years this year. We make choices that we're going to allow our relationship to grow. This isn't married that we went and got a marriage license, we said our vows, and it was on automatic for then on. That's not possible. I don't know of anybody that's been their total relationship. It takes an effort. We've had to work, we've had to walk. We've had to learn how to grow. We've had to do, I'll just say, spiritual or marital health checkups. But you see, we know that it's important for us. We love each other just as we love God. But you see, there is a responsibility that we have to check our spiritual health. I want you to think about this. We're going to go into the scriptures, but I want you to think about this. If you are a person that takes vitamin mineral supplements, they're good for helping you to maintain good health. Because there's a lot of nutrients that just in our modern food is just kind of washed out. So we need a supplementation. And if you ingest calcium, nutrients, iron, fiber, hoping that they'll stimulate your physical well-being, there's got to be a little bit more. There's got to be a little bit more. They'll help your physical well-being, but also don't neglect the spiritual aspects of your life just as well. How do you supplement your spirit? In other words, what do you take in? If you're taking in vitamins, it's something you have to do. Nobody's forcing you to do it. You put the vitamins in your hand, you take them down with a glass of water or a glass of juice, and it's a choice you make. It's a choice you make to improve your health. So don't forget that God is the one that provides for ways to increase, supplement, if you will, improve upon our mental health, our emotional health, our spiritual peace, our learning to be satisfied, our growth in life, our strength to endure. So, all of these things are well beyond just the normal day-to-day routine of I did it once and I don't need to do anything else. Be like this. You ate a breakfast, you ate a lunch, you ate a dinner, and that's the rest of your life. That's all you need. What about tomorrow, the next day, the next week, next month? How are you going to get through and continue to grow? Let's look what Peter says. In 2 Peter chapter 1, we're going to look at this. These are areas where, if you will follow them, you will be in a growth pattern. You will be growing. You will be supplementing. And you will be in the process. And I use the word process of working or walking out your own salvation. There's a song that I often play, and you've heard portions of it called Limitless. You see, I believe that God has placed within us a limitless potential. It's there, but we have to exercise it. We have to make it grow. We have to make it stronger. I walk every day. Not every day. I walked a little bit today, only about a mile, because I wanted to take my dog with me. Because it was cool, and it's good exercise for my dog, but it's so hot, usually it's not good for his feet. He gets overheated because he's a black dog with a brown undercoat. So, that isn't real good in the Texas heat. And by the time we got done with a mile today, he was ready for a rest. But you see, We have a responsibility to grow individually. And when we grow individually in our faith, we are a part of the body of Christ. And as we grow and we get stronger, and other people who are within the body of Christ, when they do the same thing, think about it. If we exercise our bodies, the various elements, our arms, our legs, all the different parts, our stomach, we get the six-pack abs, I have a barrel abs, you know. But when we do that, we get stronger. We as a body get stronger. We as individuals get stronger. But let's see what Peter says. He says this: as we grow with Christ, His divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of Him who called us by glory and virtue. I'll say that again. He has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of Him, through the knowledge of Jesus, who called us by glory and virtue, by which have been given to us exceedingly great and precious promises, that through these you may be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. In other words, these are the gifts, these are the promises that have been given to us by God through Jesus Christ in the power and the love of the Holy Spirit, that we can move and grow and be strong enough to move through all of the elements we see that want to distract us or destroy us in the world today. Verse 5, but also for this very reason, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, to virtue knowledge, to knowledge self-control, to self-control perseverance, to perseverance godliness, to godliness brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness love. If you read through this, I'm in chapter 1, 2 Peter. I started at verse 3 and I'm reading down. When you get the opportunity, read through the verses that I'm going through, because these are the elements. These are the supplements. These are the results of being supplemented that will cause you to grow, to be healthy in Christ. And these are the foundations for working out and walking out and demonstrating your salvation on a daily basis. Continuing on in verse 8, for if these things are yours and abound, you will be neither barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. For he who lacks these things is short-sighted, even to blindness, and has forgotten that he was cleansed from his old sins. Therefore, brethren, be even more diligent.